Hello, beautiful people. It's Quinton from the Hunters of Light. And today we're still talking Elements Month. And I've got Alexius van Westhuizen to come in and chat to us about his lightning shots. Hunters of Light, lightning. I think it's a good fit. There's just so much to say about lightning. I love it. I love the crash, boom, bang, the clouds that precede it. The one thing that I'm not a fan of, obviously, is when it takes out your computer. So as soon as something like that happens on the horizon, we're into the office pulling out cables, moving hard drives away, etc. But there's some fantastic shots there. I can't wait for you guys to check it out. If you're watching this for the first time, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Remember to, if you like it, hit the like button, subscribe, notification bell, all that good stuff. By subscribing, you help us to grow the channel, and we can reach more people to educate, motivate, and inspire, which is the reason why the Hunters of Light was started. So yeah, enough talk. Cue the intro. All right, so now you've had a bit of an intro into Alexius's work and what we're going to be talking about today. I thought, as it's Elements Month, we'll do something a little bit exciting and talk about lightning. I mean, lightning is a fascinating thing. I know in the times that I've tried to, capture it, I just never get it. Whether it's the fact that I'm old and my reactions are slow, no idea. So I think we'll hand it over to the experts. We'll give Alexius the floor, and then we can get some hints and tips and hopefully go out and take some lightning shots like he does. So Alexius, the first thing that I want to find out is, how long have you been photographing lightning?
Well, it all started in 2013. My very first lightning shot was how can I put it? It was just a single shot, no context, no background, foreground, whatever. It was just the one lightning bolt. And that was my inspiration to get more. Well, the inspiration was to try and shoot lightning. It's near impossible thing to shoot if you've never done it before. And I just had this passion to and this drive to start shooting it. The very first lightning storm that I shot was in 2013. November 2013 was a particularly active year in terms of lightning storms. And, it's quite coincidental that this morning, just before we went live with our feed, I just went through my Facebook memories, and we had our very first lightning last night. And 8 years ago, 2013, we had our very first lightning as well. So from that perspective, if we have to, if we're going to have the same weather pattern as 8 years ago, hopefully in November this year, we're going to have extremely heavy storms. There was a period of 2 weeks in 2013. The very first slide that that I'm going to be sharing is one of the very first storms that I got, and exactly 2 weeks later, on the 27th of November, I got my first major lightning pick. And what's just quite funny is that I never realized that I got that lightning pick until, I think, 5 months later. I was busy editing wedding photographs, and I got bored. And I thought, I had this thing in my head the whole time that there's got to be something more from that evening, something that I'm missing. And lo and behold, I went through the shots, and there was a series of, I think, 43 exposures that I totally overlooked. Wow. It was, I sat here and I thought, but hang on, I've never seen this or never looked at these exposures before. I've never processed them. And I started throwing them into, and that stage I used star stacks. I wasn't too au fait with Photoshop, and I don't even think I had Lightroom at that stage. So okay. I threw these things into star stacks, and a few minutes later, I had this massive display of lightning, 43 exposures taken over a period of 10 minutes. And wow. The lightning just fills the entire frame. So yeah, in short, since 2013.
Sure, that's crazy. I mean, the fact that that you can have a memory that goes back to almost the exact day, and as you say, the we did have some lightning last night. that's pretty cool. When it comes to your equipment, what do you use to? I'm assuming obviously a wide angle lens. And that sort of thing. But how do you go about capturing those sorts of things? Is it obviously the equipment that you've got, to the lenses, etc. But how do you go about actually capturing those shots? You just leave it open, and wait for it, or do you have like a one of those myops triggers or something like that?
Yeah, that's the question.
Yeah,
I think we lost a bit. Sorry, I thought we lost a bit of feed. Sorry, my mistake. The equipment. Yeah, a lot of people ask me whether I use triggers and those kind of things, and how am I able to actually get the lightning? Like I always say, shooting the lightning is the easy part. It is finding the lightning that's the most difficult part.
Right.
Some people are in locations where they literally have to step out onto their front porch. They put the camera down. I saw on the Isle of Four Ways feed this morning, the guy was busy photographing the sunset, and the next moment lightning started. So some people wow. are in that position where they, where they have the lightning. But to come back to the question, no, I just, all I do is leave the shutter open, close it, and open it up again. Now, in the beginning, when I started, I did not have a set time for leaving the shutter open. I would open the shutter, wait for lightning, and then close the shutter again, and then reopen it. And only later in time did I realize it's going to be much easier if I just open the shutter for, let's say, 6 seconds at a time or 8 seconds at a time, depending also on the amount of the amount of ambient light available.
Yeah, absolutely.
Or, present at the moment. If it is close to sunset and there's quite a lot of ambient light, then I open the shutter for about 2 seconds, obviously playing around with ISO and aperture. To complete the triangle, I step down to, let's say, ISO 50, increase my aperture to about 15, 16, somewhere around there, and see if that works to enable me to leave the shutter for open for 2 seconds without recording too much of the ambient light. The golden path, however, is ISO 100, 6 seconds, at an aperture of about 8, f8. That I find is when it's sufficiently dark, that is your perfect exposure time. And literally, it's a question of opening the shutter, and when 6 seconds comes and it closes, you just open it up again. I've had a lot of instances where I get excited when I see that I got a strike. So I want to go back to the frame and have a look at it. And in that process, I met two or three other strikes as well.
Exactly, exactly.
But that's literally how I do it. The big thing is finding the lightning. And in the beginning, I had a friend who... And you'll notice that the setting for the very first quite a few frames into the slideshow, I had a friend who did security at a particular shopping center. He was an ex-policeman. Unfortunately, he recently passed away due to COVID. But he would sit in his vehicle at this shopping center doing security for the pick and pay. And he would give me a call and say, listen, I've just spotted lightning. Don't you want to get your camera here? So I would go over there and set up the camera and start the process of recording the lightning. And so I was able to capture a hell of a lot of lightning from one particular spot. But I felt that over time, I developed the sense of determining where the lightning is going to be. I live in an area which is very prone to lightning. South of Johannesburg, we catch the storms as they move up from the Free State. So it's almost like I get them first, and it moves through to the northern parts of Johannesburg and Victoria and beyond. That made it easy for me to suss out where it's going to be. It's only later in time that I started using technology. There was a sort of a website application quite a while ago. I can't even remember what the name was, but that would give you the lightning in the past 10 minutes. So it would display little spots of where the lightning was.
Right.
Nowadays, I make use of the Windy app, and also Lightning Alarm, because Lightning Alarm is quite close to real time. So I use those to sort of give me an indication of how the storm is moving, if it's moving up from the Free State, and then just move up from there, get myself in position, and then just start recording. But that's basically how I do it. So no triggers involved, all just manual exposure, setting up of your ISO, and your shutter speed in order to, that you got to get ready before the time, and then you just start shooting.
Oh, that's very cool. I mean, in an age where everyone is obsessed about gear and, that you must have all the right tools and et cetera, et cetera. It seems as though, that you don't have to have all of that. You can pretty much go out there and use the sort of knowledge that you have create some pretty cool images. I suppose the other thing as well, as with any genre that we've had on the Hunters of Light, practice. The more you practice, the luckier you get. And I think even for lightning photography, it rings true.
Absolutely correct. That is, I live by that motto of Gary Player: the more you practice, the luckier you get. And that's literally what's been happening, because I've been able to get myself into positions where no other people were able to get there. And it's literally a question of every summer when it starts, I get out there and I start shooting. I think a lot of people have caught on to this, and I've also shared a lot of knowledge on essay photography on Facebook and other platforms, where right. I've been able to enable people to use that kind of knowledge that I've gained over the years to get out there and successfully do it. However, a lot of people battle with it, exactly because the fact that they don't practice it very often. It's something right. that you can't just do haphazardly when you would like it. If you want to catch continuous lightning storms, you've got to get out there every day. You've got to know your weather patterns. You've got to know how the weather is moving, where your storms will be coming from. You've got to take a look at watch the news every night so you can watch the weather prediction. You have a look at that. You use your apps like Windy. Take a look at the next few days. See what the weather pattern's going to be like, what your cloud cover is going to be like, chances of precipitation, all those kind of things. And what a lot of people are scared of is, I'm going to get wet. I can't afford my equipment to get wet and all those kind of things. The lightning literally precedes your precipitation. So you won't have, you won't have the problem of getting equipment wet and getting stuck in rain and getting struck by lightning. If that's, Some people have an issue with that as well. They reckon it's not safe. But if you know what you're doing, and like I said, that only comes with practice. Yeah. That's how you're able to get out there and get successful shots. You'll see in one of my slides, I was at Cresta, and luckily I had my camera with me. I sensed that it was going to start raining. I took out the camera, propped it up on the tripod, and the next moment, about 45 meters away from me, a lightning bolt struck down. Wow. That is the closest I got to an actual bolt. I also had the pleasure. I don't know if it, I can call it pleasure, but I was on the roof of the Joburg Civic Center in Bromfontein. Luckily, I had a friend who worked there, and he got me access to the roof. And I just finished shooting in the direction of Brixton Tower. Got a nice few sets of lightning bolts. And the weather pattern changed completely, or the lightning pattern changed completely. It went from earth to ground, or earth to cloud, to intercloud. And it felt like something was walking on the back of my head. And as I lifted my arm like this, I felt my arm hairs go stand upright. Wow. And then I just felt it. I was completely covered in static. And you know what they say is that when you feel that you're covered in static, you must watch out, because that means a lightning bolt is about to strike right next to you or on you. That's the signs that you've got to look out for. And I immediately I decided, that's it. I've got my shots. I'm getting out of here. That was the first time I actually got scared of lightning. Those are always aspects that you also got to look out for, because you know it's great to get out there and get the shots and get carried away and overstay your welcome. And also the other thing is always wear rubber boots.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think like wildlife photography. If you're going and shooting wildlife and you're going on like a walking safari, well, you know, there's a couple of inherent dangers. The same with the shooting lightning. You know, the closer it gets, the more chance you have of being hit. So I think let's check out some of your images. You know, I think we got a sense of what we need to do to get the images. So the next time we see a bit of lightning on the horizon, we can all jump in our cars and go and find it. But yeah, let's check out some of your images. I'm very keen to see all of these and check out what I need to do to be able to get these shots.
Okay, great. And what I said earlier, and that's what's quite important if you want to get great shots, is know your locations, know where you can photograph, where you're going to get, where you're not going to get harassed by a shopping center security. Look, a shopping center is probably your safest place to shoot from. Over the years, I've managed to find quite a number of locations in my area. And that only comes from driving out and scouting out your locations before the time. And even during a storm, go drive around and see where your lightning strikes and have a look at where you can find places that you can safely start shooting from. This very first image was shot from a shopping center here in the south, shooting towards the north. It's called Kamara Crossing Shopping Center. Luckily, they did not have, at that time, sharp enough security. You know, nowadays security, when they see a camera and a tripod, they're on to you as quickly as anything. I mean, a robber can walk through there with a gun and hold up 10 stores, and they'll be none the wiser. But with regard to a camera, they're always on you. So arrange with the management of the shopping center before you go there, and get yourself in a position where they've got permission and they know exactly what you're doing there, and just to prevent that sort of situation, right, where you get chased away. But yeah, this was taken in 2 weeks before the 27th of November. where I got that beautiful other lightning storm. I think this was close to about the 13th or somewhere out there, shooting north towards Johannesburg, but you can't see Johannesburg in the distance. Then 2 weeks later, on the 27th of November, I stood in exactly the same location.
Crazy.
Under roof. This photograph is a collection of, or a composite of, 43 exposures. I'm not too sure how many lightning bolts there are. I've tried counting, but, you know, there's so many branches of it that you can't accurately say how many lightning exposures you have. And if you think back to the first photograph or the first slide, it was taken in exactly the same direction. I just stood back with this shot and got myself under roof, because there was a bit of rain preceding this as well, and then the lightning just bolted. Now, this storm carried on for more than 2 hours. This is only a snippet or a collection of 10 minutes worth of that storm. So it shows you the veracity of how bad lightning can be. And, you know, you always think that it's very close. I think that was probably about 2 kilometers away from me. So, it's an incredible sight to behold. You don't get to see the full extent of it until you sit in front of your computer and you start editing and you compile them together. I always think that I never got that much, but then when I sit in front of the computer and open it up and start with a composite, then I realize the extent of the storm and how bad it really was. And the insurance companies have a field day with this, or field day with this. You know, it's they get so many claims, so many places they get hit, and yeah, it's quite severe. This photograph, incidentally, when my lightning photographs got released internationally, this was a double page spread in the Times in London. They only have 4 of those a year. And I was lucky enough to get one of those 4 spots. And this photograph also made it to the calendar of the World Meteorological Organization's calendar for 2016. And it got displayed at the UN. So I'm quite proud of this photograph. It formed part of their campaign, Hotter, Wetter, Drier, all to do with earth warming.
Okay.
Now, if you think back, this was taken in 2013. So we haven't had severe storms like that again since that time. But, you know, let's hope that this year, given the fact that we had our first lightning last night, that we're going to have a repeat of this pattern again.
Absolutely. Get some more incredible shots like that.
That, absolutely. That's that's what I'm aiming for. From the complex that I live in, I can also, I shoot in various directions. I've got quite a nice view. This view is of a house in Bessonia. It's on one of the hills in Bessonia in the south of Johannesburg. And this was also included in the international release that I had a number of years ago. The Huffington Post also released these photographs. And that was taken almost in exactly the same, you know, if I said the same time period. Your lightning, your really severe storms and great storms where you catch a lot of lightning, they'll only start in November. Before November, you get, you know, a spot here and there. But
right.
November is your real good time for lightning. From November right through until about the end of March, that's when they start dying down. But I've had lightning until, gee, goodness, sometimes within the month of April. So, you know, it all depends on the weather patterns, but that's generally when you can start looking out for good lightning storms.
So here's a question about, you know, your images being used by publications. Do you charge for those publications to use them, or are you just basically wanting to, you know, get them out there and sort of, I suppose, you know, have your name being out there and more people being aware of it?
When I started, that's exactly what I did. I posted on Facebook and I try to make them go viral. They got a lot of attention, but they never really went viral. I then had and I don't know if you're aware of Daniel Bourne from Great Stock. He was with Great Stock at the time. He actually approached me and asked me if they can do an article about me and publish the lightning photographs. So he then released it internationally, and it got snapped up by quite a number of publications. Huffington Post being one of them, The Times,
right,
in London, ParisMatch.com, and a number of publications from Europe right through to China. I think there were some in America as well. But they then bought the articles with the photographs and for publication, and I got royalties from that. Subsequent to that, I was also interviewed by Darren Simpson at the time, and a lot of people then started ordering lightning prints from me. But that had its day and time, and I think the article was released in 2015. So from 2015, the hype sort of died down. It's just your photographers who are now keen on getting into this and who have now right. climbed onto the bandwagon. But, you know, that's, I had my day and time, my 15 minutes of fame. It was great, but it's now over, you know.
until the next most amazing storm that comes around, and, you know, there's double the amount of lightning strikes in a single image. You never know.
Yeah. That would be just amazing, hey. The photograph you're looking at now is also, this is actually two exposures. And it can just show you how intense it can really get. You know, also shot from the complex from which I live in, in the direction of Soweto. Two exposures with an intense amount of lightning in it. So that's the kind of lightning that I get in my area. And if you have a very nice vantage point, you are very lucky. This is also one of the shots from one of my vantage points here in the south, looking out towards Johannesburg. I think this was shot on New Year's Eve in 2014. Looking towards Johannesburg, getting the lightning storms from what's happening behind Johannesburg, so the northern suburbs of Johannesburg. I mean, light travels incredibly fast. So you're able to shoot lightning. I think about two years ago, one evening I was in Alberton, and I stopped at a garage and I noticed lightning. And I looked on the lightning alarm app, and that lightning was actually in Secunda. So sure. I was experiencing the storm that was happening in Secunda all the way into to Alberton. So you're able to shoot storms from quite a far distance, which makes it great for safety and those kind of
absolutely.
Things. So, the next image also taken from the same vantage point, looking out towards that's just to the east of Hillbrow. I think that's in the direction of Malvern, Kensington, and those kind of areas. Once again, this is taken from the
look
complex.
At that.
That was actually on Christmas Day, as the evening approached. There was a bit of wind around. It calmed down. It got very hot, and it's almost like being in an incubator. It got extremely hot, and then the next moment, the lightning just started. I was lucky enough to catch the light trail of an aeroplane to the, you know, if you look in the right corner,
yes,
an airplane that was traveling from the west to, you know, made a turn to the south. But yeah, an incredible amount of lightning once again. And luckily, I didn't have to move very far. I literally just stepped out my back door, planted the tripod, and just started shooting.
That's very convenient.
Incredibly, hey. Once again, this is now taken from the other vantage point where most of our shots were taken from, looking out over onto the hills that precede Kensington, Malvern, and all those kind of places in Yeovil. And then on the,
wow,
and I'm trying to
that's
think
amazing.
Of the date, I think it was on the 10th of February 2015, just before the publication was released, they were asking me for more shots. And I said to them, hold on, I've got a feeling there's going to be more. And I literally drove out to the vantage point, planted the camera, and started shooting the direction of Joburg. And I just collected a wide range of shots. This was actually over a period of about 2 hours, or no, I think it was about an hour and a half. But yeah, once again, shows you up until February what kind of storm I was able to record.
That's incredible, just the amount of lightning that's there.
Yeah. This is just once again from the Kamara Crossing shopping mall, shooting in that same direction. If you look, take a look at the landmarks, you'll notice the direction or the, you know, the area is the same area where I get a lot of lightning from. This also in the suburb of Odeen, looking out over onto the hills, I am able to, and I'm quickly going to run through a number of slides here. This actually appeared in the Daily Mail in England a number of years ago. I think it was in 2016. Also one evening, and it just shows you the same location, the same intensity of lightning, just a different shade. Here you've got where you can actually see a cross-section of the cloud and the lightning following or coming through from that. This also, once again, the story behind this. This was on New Year's Day as the evening approached. We didn't have a cloud in the sky. I just had this feeling that I was going to be able to shoot lightning that day. And I... like I say, there wasn't a cloud in the sky. I drove out that evening. First drove out to the hills east of this spot where I shot this photograph from. I noticed lightning in the very far east, and that's direction Springs, Benoni. But the lightning was very far. And the next moment, something caught my attention. I noticed flashes in the corner of my eye, and I turned my attention towards Joburg. Got into my car, drove out to my usual spot.
Yeah.
Put the tripod down, attached the camera, and just started shooting. And I was able to get this. And you know what fascinates me about this kind of lightning is that you're able to get the branching of the lightning. That's what makes it so beautiful. You know, the further you're away from your lightning storm, all you get are little strips of light. And
right,
you don't get much definition in them. What I'm after is getting that definition, you know, getting the branches of the lightning and seeing how they spread out. You know, that's what's fascinating. And, you know, I've been able to get myself in positions where I quite regularly get something like that. So, I mean, this was taken from Clearwater Mall in Roodepoort. Also, I had my camera with me, and I noticed the storm. Got out, got myself into position, and was able to capture this.
Well, I suppose that's the thing. You know, you've got the opportunity to, you know, to take these pictures, but only if you've got your equipment with you. You know, if you are in that particular lightning season, I assume you take your camera with you wherever you go.
Absolutely correct, because I travel around. I do a lot of architectural and property photography. So I do travel around to a lot of places where I have to have my camera with me. And, you know, that's exactly what I've been doing since 2013, is have my camera with me, be prepared, know exactly what my settings must be, and then just take it out when the time is right and start shooting. This was the lightning bolt that struck down very close to me at the Cresta shopping mall. That was literally about, like I say, between 45 and 50 meters away from me.
Sure.
The most incredible bang. The sky just turned dark. As you can see, it illuminates all the drops of rain. And it started raining just as the lightning started as well. And then the rain stopped, and I was able to get this photograph, shooting in between scaffolding, but also getting beautiful shots as the sun was going down. Once again, back to my favorite haunt, which is the Kamara Crossing Shopping Center, looking out towards the
south. It clearly delivers very well for you, that spot.
Absolutely. Hey, I cannot tell you how many times I've just driven up there, got myself into position and started shooting. It really is a wonderful position to shoot from. But so is the whole south of Johannesburg. This is another one of those where I was shooting out towards the Eye of Africa. I actually positioned myself in the suburb of Milbarton, looking southwest, the direction where the lightning bolts actually started there. That is over an area called Walkerville and Aikenhof. And then also there's an Eye of the Gulf Estate is called Eye of Africa. And I've been able to get a lot of shots in that direction. Also, as with all the others, you're at a vantage point that is quite high, where you look out over onto the surrounding environment. This was shot from another mall of the South, and the lights that you see very close to that lightning bolt is actually one of the Rand water plots. So that's also in the direction of Eye of Africa and Aikenhof in those areas. This is back in Oakdean, and there's a little spot. I don't know if you can see it, but you can actually see the Hillbrow Tower.
Yes.
In that gap, there's that one single lightning. If I maybe point the right over there,
yeah.
Can you see my mouse pointer? Yeah, that's Hillbrow Tower. So this was shot from, and if I'm going to move it to the pointer to the right, Kamara Crossing Shopping Center, where I get most of my lightning from. That's actually that area where I'm pointing at right now. So here I was standing in the hills of Masonia shooting out towards Johannesburg.
It's incredible. I really like these wide-angled shots.
You know, and that's always a toss-up between wide angle and going a little bit narrower than wide. Because if the lightning storm is quite far away from you, the wider the angle, the smaller your bolts are going to be.
Right.
So you got to get yourself, if they are far away from you, get yourself very close to the action by putting on a, let's say, a 24 to 70 or even a 70 to 200 and just getting a little bit closer to the action. Otherwise, you're going to have you know, they're going to be too wide. Luckily, I've been able to get myself in a position where I can get quite close to the action. And once again, like I say, know your environment, do your preparation before the time, and, you know, work from there. And let that be, you know, do your homework. Get out there and prepare yourself. And, yeah, you'll be able to get incredible lightning shots if you just prepare to do your homework and get to know your environment. Right. This was actually taken from Mall of the South as well. And I can't even remember the year that this was. Also, once again, looking out over onto Eye of Africa, Akenoff, those areas. And this was quite funny how this happened as well. This was also in December, quite hot. I looked through the window towards the south, and I noticed some lightning in the illumination in the clouds. Got into my car, literally drove 5 minutes to this spot. And I got this beautiful, beautiful bolt of lightning. And I didn't include the shot that I got afterwards, because that was just, once again, an insane collection of lightning, you know, that I was able to get. Now, over the years, my style has changed, where I would fit as many as possible lightning shots into one frame. But, you know, it gets very busy, and I find that your singular lightning shots are so much prettier than, you know, than having this whole big set of lightning bolts. It gets very busy.
I must say, I quite enjoy the singular ones. It kind of almost feels compositionally nicer than having all of them. But I suppose each of them has got a place. You know, if you have a massive panorama of, 40 or 50 lightning strikes, that's just as incredible as, a single shot like this.
Absolutely correct, you know. And so I've been going over the years, going for singular lightning shots. And where I get more than that, I try not to fill the frame with too many. This was actually shot from the roof of the Civic Center as well. Looking out, you can see Joburg General Hospital in the foreground, or the Charlotte Mateke Hospital. And that, I think, was in the direction of just behind Midrand, if I'm not mistaken. There's another shot taken on the same evening. I like to see the definition. You know, like you say, there's a place and time for your collection of shots and also those singular ones that really compositionally stand out. This was the evening that I started feeling the static when I got covered in static, just after taking the last shot that I composed this scene with. I started feeling that, the static, and I decided to get off. I thought to myself, very few people know that I'm actually on the building. So what happens if there is a lightning strike? If they've got lightning conductors, but even so, you know, the chances of getting hit by lightning it was a danger. Well, I thought it was a danger at the time, and I thought, back of that, I'm getting off this building. I got my shots, but it's something that only scared me literally that once. But that comes from knowing your environment and knowing where to push yourself to. You got to know your limits. Back to Mall of the South. Sorry, did you want to ask a question?
No, I was just going to say, you've got to trust your instincts, etc. When it comes to that. But I've got something about this one as well. That I just love the lighting on those clouds underneath, you know, where the start of that strike is. It's, oh man, it's amazing.
Absolutely, hey, and you don't see this with the naked eye, and that's the pleasure of being able to shoot in RAW and draw back on your highlights. When you start editing the photograph, I actually started shooting when the sun was quite high on this one, And the lightning was very far away from me, I think in the direction of Mayerton. And I had a number of shots in the direction of Mayerton, and then all of a sudden it just turned. And it started bolting down. And what I love seeing is also where it strikes. And if you have a look there, where it strikes, you can actually see the ground being illuminated as well. but this is something you don't see with the naked eye. You see the bolt, but the definition of the bolt and what it does to the clouds and how it veins through the clouds, that is absolutely amazing to see.
Yeah.
From the very same, this was actually from the very same afternoon, I was able to extract a number of singular bolts from the composition that I made in the end. And this is also one single exposure, two bolts striking down quite close to each other. Exactly as well, one frame, one exposure, beautiful definition to the lightning bolts. Very similar to that very first one that you saw, but with less little clouds around and that also the clouds move, and it's amazing to see how the storm actually moves and the clouds move over a period of time.
Now, these are beautiful. I love them.
And then I started composing, getting as many bolts together as I can. Here I actually toned them down, so I used less in this one. This was shot from a copy which overlooks the Mall of the South, where the preceding number of slides was that I showed you. This was one evening shooting out into the direction of Mayerton. Incredible collection of lightning in the clouds and earthy cloud lightning. Just like I say, I'm very fortunate in the area that I live in that I'm able to actually to get such collections of lightning shots. This was a shot from the Reef Hotel, from the Elevate Bar at the Reef Hotel. I did not go out to shoot lightning. I wanted to get a few cityscapes of Joburg. And the next moment, the lightning just started bolting down. And I propped up the camera behind it. And unfortunately, there they've got a lot of glass.
Right,
so I didn't
yes.
have a polarizing filter to shoot with, and I very seldomly shoot with any filters. I had to do a lot of cleaning up of the reflection in the glass, of light and stuff like that. So I was able to clean it up quite nicely, and the old Standard Bank building is quite nicely framed with two bolts or a little bit more of lightning as you can see over there, which is quite nice. If you crop this into a vertical format, portrait format, it also looks quite nice where you single out that building and get the lightning around it.
Right. I love the colors as well. It's really nice.
Yeah, this is an example of your late season lightning. When the storms start dying down, you start getting cross section of clouds. And if you look at the top, you can also see star trails and stuff like that as well. So, thrown in just to give you an idea of late in the season, right about the end of March into April, what you're still able to shoot. This is once again back to my favorite haunting spots in Glen Vista and the hills of Bessonia, looking out towards the west. Once again, the storms come from the south and the west, and I just sit and wait for them. Great. This was shot from the rooftop in of a building in Rosebank. You know, I was quite lucky to get this because I was shooting towards the south. And a friend phoned me and he said he can spot a lot of lightning to the north of me. And I said, well, that's it. I phoned a friend of mine who lives in a building in Rosebank and said to him, listen, do you want to shoot some lightning? He said, great, I'll organize access. And we got to the rooftop and I only got three frames of lightning. And this was the combination of those three frames. But once again, you know, if you get a beautiful foreground, I'm not saying this is entirely beautiful, but, you know, you get an interesting foreground. Then it really adds to the compositional beauty of the photograph, where it's not just a bolt of lightning striking down in the middle of nowhere. You've got to add some context to it, you know, and I think there's a lot of value in that, where you can see your surrounding area and stuff like that.
I agree 100%.
This is back to Mall of the South. The previous number of slides that I showed you. And this is also back in the hills of Masonia, shooting out to exactly the same spot, Akenhof, Eye of Africa, late afternoon, getting myself into position before the time and being able to, and there you can see the clouds as well, you know, the lightning veining through the clouds and branching out through there. Also, single exposure, the more you practice, the luckier you get.
Eh? Absolutely. I mean, I think for me, first of all, they're amazing. I think for, you know, everyone that looks at photographs are going to say, well, I prefer this and I prefer that, et cetera, et cetera. And I think for me, the parts where there's the sort of singular strike, you know, slightly wider, those resonate with me quite nicely. But then at the same time, you know, we've got this panorama of you know, loads and loads and loads of shots that I love as well. So, you know, I mean, I think that when it comes to lightning photography, there's probably something for everyone. You know, if you prefer that sort of, you know, mass of lightning strikes and the branches, etc., fantastic, shoot and combine those. And if you prefer just that solitary strike with a, you know, building on the right and a little bit of foreground, just fantastic, you know. So I really enjoyed it, and I think it's I do a lot of cloudscapes, and funnily enough, I do them from my garage roof. I'm not sure that I can do lightning strikes from my garage roof, you know. But I'm definitely keen to have a look at some spots that I think you know, I could use as vantage points for some lightning photography. So I appreciate your showing us what can be done and that sort of thing. And then I also wanted to say at this time, a bit of housekeeping. If you've watched this for the first time, thank you very much. Really appreciate it. If you liked it, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit the notification bell, so that next time we post something like this, you can get notified and check it all out. If you are a subscriber, thank you. Appreciate it. You guys rock. You know, that's really how we grow the channel, liking, subscribing, et cetera, et cetera. And we can bring you more of this kind of content, which I think is really, really cool. Even if you never want to shoot lightning photography in your life, you know, certainly just looking at the pictures are amazing. So Alexius, I wanted to say thank you very much for your time today. I can't wait to post it and show everyone.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for having me, and thank you for the Hunters of Light channel, YouTube, Facebook, all those kind of things. It promotes what we love and what we're passionate about, and thank you for that.
Absolutely. It's a pleasure. I mean, you know, it started off, you know, over what, year and a half ago, with just trying to inspire and motivate people when they'd sort of lost their bookings, etc. And I think the, you know, over time, it's morphed into slightly bigger plans than there were. And I think over time it will probably morph again into what it will eventually be going forward. So, but I appreciate that. Thank you so much. I'm glad that you're getting something out of it, and I really hope that everyone else is as well. Cool. Thanks, Alexius. Appreciate it.
Excellent. Have a wonderful day.
You too. Cheers.
Bye.